At what point, and it is that element of discretion, at what point does a referee think, well, does he not have to equalise it and let two QPR players have a little bit of a nibble back? How does he make that decision? And what's the thinking behind it where they then decide to go for it and take the card out?
Yeah, you look at that game, and obviously Mike's taken into account the conditions, which look pretty difficult there. And when you look at the first tackle by Clichy, he comes in, he slides in. I think the condition of the pitch is something that affects that, and he plays some of the ball. I think Mike takes that into account. And then the next tackle is one where there's not a great deal of contact. And I think he thinks, you know, I can probably manage this without having to resort to the card. There is an element of balance of control. You know, of course, that's important. But if the next one is one that, you know, he clearly feels is later, is worse than the other ones, you have to draw the line at some point, and you have to you know, realise that, you know, the only way that you're going to get the players to, I guess, get the message is to show a caution.
But isn't a yellow card in any situation, certain time of the game, first minute, last minute, you just think, that's a yellow card. Doesn't matter what the situation is, what game it is. I think that is frustration for players at times where, as he said, the QPR players then have complained some have gone. And you're not causing a problem for yourself.
Some are, and of course it does come down to a judgment, and some situations are absolutely clear where, you know, the only outcome can never be a yellow card. And some of those that fall in the margins where, you know, an element of discretion can be used, I guess, and referees, particularly early in the game, will try to pitch their involvement in the appropriate way. Consistency is important. I mean, we get together on a really regular basis and we look at lots and lots of situations to try to gain that consistency. But each game is different, and I think all we can really ask for is that the referee is consistent within the 90 minutes of that particular game.
Is there a message from yourselves in terms of, let's say Liverpool United or a Manchester derby or a Merseyside derby, North London derby, the big games, is there a tolerance level, a message from yourselves that sort of slightly increases the bar in terms of, look, you might have to let this go a little bit further, or is there just a general level, let's have a look at the game for 5-10 minutes? Because it does seem that referees do like a look at a game and sort of, you know, particularly the big games.
I think any game you like to have a look at it, you like to see how much you need to be involved in that game. You know, the games where players play and you can take a step back and all you do is orchestrate a few bits and pieces, they're great and we all like those. But sometimes you've got to be busy from the first minute because the game demands that. People say the best referees are the ones that you don't notice, but that's not always the case. Sometimes, you know, you have to be seen and heard because the game demands that for you to keep control. So, you know, you step your involvement up. And yet, sometimes the atmosphere in the stadium is more hostile or more excitable than other ones. And sometimes, you know, that can affect the participants. And therefore, you need to be that calming influence in the game. So trying to compare, you know, like with like in games from one week to the next is not always so easy. But like I said, I think the important thing is that the referee on the day is consistent throughout the 90 minutes.
Yeah, but you talk about consistency through the 90 minutes. If you let something go and then book someone again for 20 minutes, how is that consistency through the 90 minutes?
Well, it might be that you've given an opportunity early in the game using this stepped approach towards the discipline, an opportunity to tell everybody that, you know, that's not really acceptable, but you know something, it's not absolutely clear and obvious as a yellow card. I think I can probably send a message out that if I just speak to the player, don't go rushing for the yellow card. The players might respond to that. But then, of course, something happens later, which is maybe just a little bit worse. At some point, you know, you have to step up your involvement, step up the discipline, just to get the game back under your control. And a well-timed yellow card can have a really positive effect on the game.